project, like I said. Ultimately, by the end of the week, you guys are actually going to create your own museum online, a virtual museum, okay? So what we're going to do today, we're going to go over what the project is all about. You guys are actually going to tour a virtual museum, so you have an idea of what you're going to be creating. Then we're going to cover the essential vocabulary you need to know in order to get the project done. You guys ready? All right. The content standards for history that we're working on is Islamic, specifically Islamic achievements in the world. What I really wanted them to learn out of this lesson, number one, with the content standard, I really want to know what do they think the world needs to know about the contributions of the Islamic world. But number two, the biggest priority is for them to learn those 21st century skills. So how to collaborate with each other, how to really express your creativity in something that is online and collaborative, and also how to communicate with each other. So our first word for today is museum. What is it?
Museum.
Okay, you have 1 minute. Please go ahead and get your definition down now.
Then we'll I use NearPod to teach vocabulary explicitly with them, rather than just having them write it out on a piece of paper, simply because of the tools that NearPod allows them to learn with. It allows me to give them the explicit definition. It has the different activities embedded in it that it gives me real feedback in real time, so I can tell whether they really knew it or not. You know, I can tell, can they actually visualize it through the draw it feature? I can tell if they know how to apply it with the fill in the blanks. And I can tell just based on their open responses in NearPod itself with that tool, whether they really understand how to use the word. And to me, that's so much more effective than just writing it and hoping they memorized it on a piece of paper.
So as you guys are watching the video on the next slide is, or the video is going to cover where exactly do people in museums get their artifacts, okay? So where do they get, if it's a museum on music, where do they get the guitars? Where do they get everything, okay? So as you guys are watching, you need to think to yourself, again, where do artifacts come from? How do they find them? Is that clear?
One of the vocabulary words was artifacts. And what I decided to really give them a visual example of what the vocabulary term was to embed a little video in NearPod, which it allows you to do. And the video is actually, it shows them, it leads them why what artifacts are, how archaeologists use them, and how eventually museums use artifacts in their exhibits. So the whole point with the video within the NearPod was really to give them a visual of really what is an artifact and what's the purpose of it, which if you just tell them what it is, it's not as effective.
To get a little bit more practice and to show me that you actually really understand what these words mean, we're gonna do two steps. First, we're gonna do a Quizlet so that way you guys can actually work together on really learning these words. And then second, you guys are going to do a fill in the blanks to show me that you individually know what these words mean.
I use Quizlet Live in my class when we're doing reinforcement and of vocabulary. So the way Quizlet Live works, you have a series of words and their definitions, and then it actually groups students randomly. But Quizlet Live, what it does, it's a competition, but it's a collaborative competition. So students actually have to collaboratively communicate with each other to figure out who has the vocabulary term that's going with the definition on our screen.
All right, so for the last part of our vocabulary, since we now practice together working on our words, I need you to go ahead and complete our reading here by filling in the correct vocabulary term with the correct sentence. Are we ready? Okay, I'm gonna give you guys about 3 minutes.
As far as the importance of which technology you're using, I really think there are certain types of technology that fit what your objective is. So if my objective is I want them to learn academic language, then I might use a Quizlet Live. If my objective is I want them to collaborate digitally and learn how to communicate online, I might use a Google Slides or a Google Docs where they're communicating with each other or reviewing each other's work. So I really think the technology has to fit the objective of the lesson.
So on the next slide, our database for our research, meaning where we're gonna actually conduct our research, is on something called a hyperdoc. Does anybody know what a hyperdoc is? Awesome, we're gonna learn today. So a hyperdoc is literally a Google Doc. Do we all know what a Google Doc is? Okay. And on that Google Doc, I've inserted different links to websites and places that you're going to use to research. that link that's in the hyper or that is in the Google Doc makes it a hyper doc because it's a hyperlink. Means it takes you to a website when you click on it.
The hyperdoc is a wonderful way to actually link in the resources that you think are appropriate for the task. And for middle school kids, the hyperdoc really just focuses in where I want them to go, because kids at this level still have a hard time filtering out what are good sources, what are not good sources. So within the hyperdoc, you give them options, but they're the options that you've already approved of. So it really, it focuses them and it keeps them on target of where you want them to go.
Go to your Google Classroom, and we're going to open up the assignment that says Virtual Museum Proposals. Which one?
Virtual Museum Proposals.
Excellent. Here it is. You have 1 minute. Please go ahead and Pac-Man once you have it open.
So I decided to use a Google Doc for the collaboration piece when they were actually writing their exhibit proposals, because it does allow them to actually see what the other groups are doing. And part of our process is class collaboration. This was a whole class project. And so they understood that it wasn't just individual group projects. We have to collaborate together and decide, is this the product we want to put out? And so the Google Doc is a great way for them to actually go back and review each other's work.
So what do we want to write?
What did you do nice? Like, what do you like about it?
Well, I like the pictures. They really go with, like, what they're learning about.
How detailed it is?
Yeah.
You could put that. They should, instead of, like, writing who or what, they should just write it into, like, a complete sentence. Mm-hmm. Instead of, like, little notes.
Mm-hmm. So technology is really embedded as part of the class itself, not just something they do on the side or something to replace a handout. And the reason why I think is technology doesn't replace my teaching. I'm still the teacher, but I'm designing a lesson for them that's going to take them to the next level. It's not just learn this information and give it back to me. It's let's create something, let's produce something to show how well you know this and how well you can teach it back to me or you can teach other people in the world. I don't go away because there's technology, let's put it that way. But technology helps me bring it to another level.